Westerlin, and I work in the clinical department at Open Sky Community Services. I've been asked to talk to you about sleep challenges. So one of the things I just wanted to put out there is, you know, hey, there's a lot going on in our world right now that is really uncertain, and this can be something that can cause a lot of us to have sleep challenges, right? There's a lot of worries on our mind, there's a lot of unknowing and uncertainty, and that can really make it hard to get a good night's sleep. So full disclosure, I just wanted to put out there that I happen to be someone who experiences sleep challenges from time to time. So not only is it part of my role to coach people on different strategies they can use to get a good night's sleep, but I also have to heed my own advice, right? I can just speak to the idea that it's not really that easy. A lot of the recommendations for getting a good night's sleep are about looking at your schedule and making some small adjustments. And we all know changing habits, changing our routine can be a really hard thing to do. So let's jump into some of the tips. So one of the first things that we want to try to do is take a look at our routine and make sure that we have a routine, right? So it's really important to be getting up and going to bed at the same time every night. Right now, during our, you know, uncertain times, it can be really disruptive to our regular routine. So as much as possible, try to develop a new routine that allows you to have more structure and consistency with your bedtimes and things like that. It's recommended that you have a good night routine. So basically having a way that you're winding down at night, you're doing relaxing things as you're getting ready for bed. And there are certain things that you want to try to avoid. So avoid doing any strenuous exercise before bed, avoid caffeine before. 5 p.m. is probably like the cutoff point for a lot of people. And that includes things like caffeine, and chocolate, and you know, any other stimulant. So we're also want to consider, you know, if you use nicotine products, really making sure that with that you're not having any nicotine at least an hour before bed. So anything that's going to kind of like amp you up, you want to make sure that you're not doing those in the time where you're trying to wind down and slow yourself down in terms of your body and your mind in order to get a good night's rest. So screens are recommended to be off at least an hour before bed. I'm not very good at this. It's really hard to do. So, but these are just some of the things that you can kind of take a look at in your routine and see if these are adjustments that you can easily make and see if it has an impact in your overall sleep. So some of the other things that, you know, can be really helpful can be, you know, listening to a podcast. So I would say that is probably my number one tip, right? I personally have found great benefit from listening to different podcasts or using apps that have a relaxation piece to them in order to help me fall asleep at night. Or if I wake up in the middle of the night with worries, I'll put one of these podcasts on or put on one of the apps and some earbuds and just, you know, these awesome sleep stories that really help you kind of distract from your own thoughts, and you listen to these ramble-on stories that kind of take you off in a different direction. And it can be really freeing and can allow you to kind of just drift off into sleep. So the two that I would recommend are the Calm app, and then also there's a podcast called Sleep With Me. So check those two out, see if those make a difference with nighttime waking or just helping you to fall asleep. So thanks everyone for listening to a couple of my tips that I have for getting a good night's sleep, and I wish you a good night.